This is the OTB Network.
Hello and welcome to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. I'm Jean Wood. We've got a busy program for you, and we're going to start at Delaware Park, where on Saturday they contested the Sussex Stakes. Unfortunately, this event did come off the turf. $100,000, three-year-olds and up going a mile and a 16th instead on a wet, fast main track. Let's head to Delaware and the Sussex.
And they're off. Look like sitcom there, stumbled pretty bad at the break there, but quickly regains his stride. Angelic Aura is going to go right to the front today and try and dictate things. Poco Moonshine racing in reserve second, followed by Play Bingo in third, then Blue finally. And sitcom is away last as they make their way into that first turn. Well off the rail is Angelic Aura, who leads it by about a length and a quarter. Toward the inside, Poco Moonshine is going to engage that one right now as they make their way around the turn. As looks like Angelic Aura wants to take back off the leader just a bit. Poco Moonshine to the front. Angelic Aura now a reserve second on the outside. Six lengths further back to Play Bingo settles in the third, followed by Blue finally and Sitcom. Opening quarter in 24-1 as they move down the backside. Poco Moonshine by a measured three-quarters length. Angelic Aura is right there in second. Then a gap of four lengths to Play Bingo. Sitcom on the outside of Blue finally as they make their way toward the half-mile marker. Half in an honest 48-1, half-mile to go. Poco Moonshine by still three parts over Angelic Aura. Two lengths to Play Bingo and Sitcom. Blue finally toward the inside of the trailer, but now only about five lengths separates this field as they make their way into the turn. Poco Moonshine by half a length with Angelic Aura right there still in second. Two lengths to Play Bingo and Sitcom, and Blue finally is at the back. 3/8 to go. Poco Moonshine, Angelic Aura are now a neck apart. Play Bingo's inching closer. Sitcom flattened out, and Blue finally trying to rally from the back with a quarter to go. The 6 1/13 as they head for home. Poco Moonshine on the front end still by a length. Now the challenge may be coming from Play Bingo. Angelic Aura is fading a little bit. Blue finally is trying to kick it in. Here comes Play Bingo rushing up on the outside to join Poco Moonshine a furlong away, and Play Bingo forges to the front. Play Bingo is going to win the Sussex Stakes by about two or three. Poco Moonshine gamely hanging in for second. Angelic Aura third.
Play Bingo picking up the victory by two lengths from just off the pace. Pace setter Poco Moonshine holding on well to finish second. And favorite Angelic Aura. All three of these horses from the main track only list getting in here on the main track, on Angelic Aura finishing in the third spot as the favorite. The winner, Play Bingo, is a bay son of Polish numbers from Poised to Pounce by Smarten, bred in Maryland by Dark Hollow Farm and William Beetson, owned by Erdenheim Farm and trained by John Fisher, ridden to victory by Rodrigo Madrigal. Play Bingo covers the mile and a 16th on the wet, fast main track at Delaware in 1:45 3. Going to head to Colonial Downs next for a trio of stakes racing, some quite interesting. We'll start with the All Along Breeders' Cup Handicap for three and up fillies and mares. Let's head down to Colonial and their lovely turf course for the All Along.
And they're off in the All Along. Art Fan takes the early initiative out to a narrow lead with Humoristic from the outside gate, and Wend is right there spying them from the inside of the opening furlong. Followed by Latisse, the late-running filmmaker. Joint Aspiration is last of all. So past the line now, and it's Art Fan and Ryan Fogelsanger gliding along at a comfortable pace in the early stages, three-quarters of a length. Humoristic Wend has been taken off the inside of the course, now out there in the clear. In the meantime, Filmmaker is just 2.5 lengths on the front. And Filmmaker's down inside there. Filmmaker almost third. Wend is to her outside. Followed by Latisse, and Joint Aspiration has about 5.5 lengths to make up, but still a long way to go. A pace advantage to Art Fan, just going along at a comfortable clip. Art Fan bounding along length and a quarter in front. Humoristic just holding second by a head. Wend is in the clear on the outside. Filmmaker elects to stay down to the inside, followed by Latisse's 3.5 to 4 from the front, and Joint Aspiration. Julia Leperu would like Joint Aspiration a little bit closer now as Art Fan tries to get away with it. Art Fan opening up, but opening up two on Humoristic. Wend is third and asks for run. Filmmaker fourth, Latisse, and Joint Aspiration plenty to do at this point, some 9 off the lead. Three Ace from home, and Art Fan is going to try to sprint away. Art Fan sprints for home now. Humoristic Wind is out after her on the outside. Filmmakers just off that fence make elect to come three wide of the quarter pole as they're at the top of the stretch. Art Fan from Wind by two. Filmmaker has to roll on the far outside. Humoristic is down on that fence with just about a furlong to go. Lettice and Never Heard From Joint Aspiration. They've got a furlong to go, and Filmmaker rolls under Dominguez. Filmmaker and Dominguez coming home, opening up three or four lengths. The classy Filmmaker by four. Lettice coming home for second. Third is going to be very tight. Art Fan followed by Humoristic When Joint Aspiration.
Filmmaker returns to the races victorious at the age of six. Her most recent race was down at Calder late last year. She had been given quite a bit of freshening time and returns to the races with a nice performance, a 3 1/4 length victory under Ramon Dominguez, a perfectly timed ride, as often is the case for Ramon, picking up the win at the expense of Lattice, who ran well from off the pace, and Art Fan, the early pace setter at 20-1, who stuck around pretty well in the final strides to finish third. A little disappointing in here was Wend under Garrett Gomez for the first time, tracking the pace. Now, she was wide. She did have a little bit of an excuse there, but she had to, she was in prime position at the top of the stretch and did come up short, finishing fifth in the field of six. The winner, Filmmaker, Dark Bayer Brown's six-year-old daughter of Dynaformer from Miss Dubois by Mr. Prospector, was bred in Kentucky by TAC Holdings and is owned by the Cortland Farm, trained by Graham Motion, and ridden to victory by Ramon Dominguez. Filmmaker covers the mile and an eighth on the Colonial turf in 1:46.2. We're going to head back to Colonial now and the Colonial Turf Cup, a $1 million event for the three-year-olds on the grass and the first leg of a big series that will culminate with a $5 million bonus for a horse that can sweep four races in a row going up to the Breeders' Cup, up to and including the Breeders' Cup turf at the end of the season. This is leg one. It's ungraded, but it's $1 million. Let's head down to Colonial and the Turf Cup.
And they're off in the Colonial Turf Cup. Kip DeVille wasting no time from the far outside post position, clearing over. Kip DeVille with good early speed has opened up 4 or 5 lengths, so the pace is going to be very quick here. Into the second spot is Lewis Michael, followed by Showing Up, who's rating hard third to the inside. Roman Dynasty is next in fourth, followed by Outperformance and Go Between. They are side by side into the first turn on Bridal Behavior. Going to be about three wide. Chin High is one widest out into the first turn. And Stream Cat, content to save some ground around the turn. International Cat is in between horses there. Shuffle back just a little bit. Then to the outside there is Can't Beat It, as International Cat has dropped back a spot or two now. Yates Black Cat is down to the inside of International Cat. It's other 5 lengths back, and Prime Diamond and Rock Lobster is that trailer. Rock Lobster is well back. Well, a spirited pace indeed. 22-2, 45-2 for the half mile from Kip DeVille, who's rolling along in a double-digit advantage. We'll call it maybe 16, 17 lengths in front in the Colonial Turf Cup. The closers ought to be suited now. Lewis Michael, the second spot. Roman Dynasty is in third, and Showing Up is in fourth. Following the outside by Go Between in fifth. Outperformance is in sixth position. Can't Beat It is seventh, while three wide around the far turn. International Cat is trying to stoke up a rally, but still about 20 lengths off the lead, followed by Unbridled Behavior. Chin High is coming under pressure, and Stream Cat is still well back at the top of the stretch. Kip DeVille, the lead is down to seven. They're coming now. Here comes Showing Up. Here comes Roman Dynasty, and here comes Lewis Michael in between horses, also rolling with a rally as well. They've got a furlong to go, and Kip DeVille laboring now, Showing Up, steaming on the outside, and Showing Up with big strides is coming to inhale. The front running Kip DeVille, who's run an absolutely monstrous race, will have to settle for second or third here. It's Showing Up to win it. Kip DeVille runs huge. Third was Go Between. It's tighter for fourth. Roman Dynasty was in there with Stream Cat in the photo.
Showing Up, making his turf debut, a winning one. And how ironic that this horse from Lael Stable, not unlike his stablemate Barbero, obviously showing considerable ability on both surfaces. He's now 4 for 5 lifetime, moves on to the turf out of a 6th place finish in the Kentucky Derby, and wins impressively by 3 1/4 lengths over Kip DeVille, who opened up an enormous 15-length lead And in my opinion, held on very well to finish second at huge odds. This is the horse that won the Grand Prairie Turf Challenge last time out at Lone Star. Not a horse to be overlooked. Go Between rallies from off the pace to finish third. The winner showing up is a chestnut three-year-old colt, a son of Strategic Mission, who stands right here in New York, out of Miss Alethea by TV Commercial. Bred in Kentucky by Nellie M. Cox and the Rose Retreat Farm and owned by Lael Stable. Trained by Barkley Tag and ridden to victory by Cornelio Velasquez, Showing Up covers the mile and 3/16 at Colonial in a new course record time, 1:52.4. We're going to return to Colonial now for their Sunday afternoon stakes feature, the Buckland. This is for three and up, fillies and mares sprinting on the turf. Let's head back to Colonial and the Buckland.
And they're off. Cap and Gown firing up from the outside. Nenscurry Bright Gold came away with the speed pack, and Kiss Me Katie is also right there, along with Spring Kitten. They're all sorting out, six of them flying right across the track now. And now that the lead is Nenscurry. Nenscurry emerges out of the speed pack, and Bright Gold are in between horses and now shuffled back just a bit, trying to stay in that speed duel is Bright Gold, and Spring Kitten is racing up on the inside. But Bright Gold wants that lead, now certainly has grabbed it into the fiery turn. Bright Gold's been hard ridden to grab a narrow lead. Kiss Me Katie racing second. Spring Kitten is next in third. And in between horses, Beautiful Bets is the gray, looming from the third spot now, is advancing well, three wide at the top of the stretch. And they turn for home. Kiss Me Katie, Bright Gold, followed in third position by Beautiful Bets, the center of the track. Bit of late run from Listen on the Far Outside, but Bright Gold now turning back. Kiss Me Katie. Third is Beautiful Bets. Closing far outside is Halloween Fun. Halloween Fun's closing gap on the far outside, but it's too late. Bright Gold, she's gone. She earned it today. Bright Gold. Bright Gold by two at the finish. Beautiful Bets was second. Halloween Fun was third. And Listen.
Bright Gold and Horacio Caramanos running well from off the pace to pick up the victory. Kind of an early move after prompting the pace. She made it to the lead fairly quickly, holding off Beautiful Bets and Halloween Fun for the victory by a length and a half. The winner, Bright Gold, is a bay mare, a daughter of Hold for Gold by Bright and Early by Northern Jove, bred in Virginia by Hazel B. Marsh and owned by the breeder, trained by Mary Epler and ridden to victory by Horacio Caramanos. Bright Gold covers this 5.5 furlongs on the Colonial turf in 101 and 4. We're going to remain in the Mid-Atlantic, head to Philadelphia Park for Saturday's running of the My Juliet, a sprint for older fillies and mares running for $100,000. Let's head to Philadelphia and the My Juliet.
And they're off. Remarkable Tail on the outside, guns right to the front. Remarkable Tail, faster than Trickle of Gold here in the opening furlong, and Remarkable Tail leads it by almost 2 lengths. Trickle of Gold running comfortably here in the first furlong and a half. She's second by a length and a half. Giovanna Gold is down inside third by a length and a half. No Time to Quit sitting fourth at the half mile pole. She's almost 5 back, and it's another 3 to stretch running Baldomera. Opening quarter over the sloppy track was 21-4. Onto the far turn, Remarkable Tail's lead down to just 3 parts of a length. On the outside, just under a hand ride, Trickle of Gold moving alongside. Giovanna Gold is only 2 lengths back at the inside. No Time to Quit is revving up with her run on the outside. Baldomera looking to lengthen stride. She's still 5 lengths away as they approach the top of the stretch. They went the half in 45-2. Trickle of Gold right at the neck of Remarkable Tail as the two turn for home together. Giovanna Gold trying to sustain her run at the inside. No Time to Quit making a late run in the middle of the racetrack. Baldomera far outside coming on. Here comes No Time to Quit. Trickle of Gold between horses. No Time to Quit forges to the front with a 16th to go and is edging away. No Time to Quit. Yes, sir. No Time to Quit has done it. Photo for second between Trickle of Gold and Baldomera.
No Time to Quit, picking up the victory on a sealed, sloppy racetrack from just off the pace, winning by a length and 3/4 from Trickle of Gold, a horse that has been running some pretty serious races in very fast time. She was the odds-on choice, perhaps a little bit of an early move to get to the lead. She did get the lead at the top of the stretch and was outfinished. Baldomera rallies from off the pace at 11-1 to finish third. The winner, No Time to Quit, is a chestnut mare, a daughter of Too Light to Quit from Ahead of the Times by Gold Alert, bred in Florida by John Franks, owned by Nicholas Chochari and Raymond Vitolo, trained by Ramon Preciado, and ridden to victory by Harry Vega. No Time to Quit covers the 6 furlongs on that sealed sloppy track in 1:10 and 4. We're going to pause now for a brief message. When we return, we'll be continuing with racing action from the Mid-Atlantic and heading towards the West as well. Please stay with us. Welcome back to Horses and Choruses. We're going to continue now at Monmouth Park in New Jersey, where on Saturday the stakes feature was the Grade 3 Salvatore Mile. Older horses going a flat mile. Typically a fairly solid race filled with maybe decent Grade 3 type of horses, some allowance type horses moving up. This one a particularly notable returnee, Flower Alley, making his 4-year-old debut. Let's head down to New Jersey in the running of the Salvatore Mile.
Racing in the Salvatore Mile. Network was slow to start. Golden Roses and Cherokee's Boy go out together. Park Avenue Ball is right behind them and down on the inside. And Flower Alley will be wide into that first turn. Flower Alley now moves up ahead of Park Avenue Ball, and he's 3 lengths off the lead. Network's been left well behind here. He's 13 lengths off the pace as Golden Roses and Chuck Lopez lead the way to the backstretch. Running an opening quarter in 23 seconds flat. Cherokee's Boy on the outside second. Flower Alley is third. He's 2 lengths off the lead. Park Avenue Ball just behind him and down on the inside. Comfortably placed in fourth. He's got 3 lengths to make up, and he's 7 lengths ahead of Network. Up the backstretch in the Salvatore Mile, and it's Golden Roses in front by a length and a half over Cherokee's Boy. Flower Alley still well held to the outside. They went a half mile in 46 2/5 seconds. Park Avenue Ball has now been guided off the rail by DiCarlo. He's 3 lengths off the lead, and it's now just 5 to Network, but he's under a heavy drive. Around the far turn, Golden Roses. Here comes the big favorite, Flower Alley. And Park Avenue Ball is up to third now, and he's in gear. Cherokee's Boy is dropping back, and Network is starting to roll from the back of the pack. He's getting an inside trip. 3/4 in 1:10 4. Into the stretch, Golden Roses and Flower Alley. Park Avenue Ball and Network are behind them. Golden Roses is stubborn on the inside. Flower Alley is now taking the lead, though. It's Flower Alley in front. And back into second is Golden Roses as Flower Alley makes a big splash in the Salvatore Mile. He comes back strong with a 4-length win over Park Avenue Ball and Network in 1:35 4.
Flower Alley getting the win by 3 1/4 lengths as the odds-on choice in a sea of slop during a terrible cloudburst under John Velasquez. A very impressive return to the races. He sat confidently off of the pace setter, New York-bred Golden Roses, Cherokee's Boy, who apparently was not handling the surface particularly well. Backing out early, Golden Roses hanging on to mid-stretch, but Flower Alley, a patient ride by John Velasquez to get the victory. Park Avenue Ball and Network both came flying late to finish second and third, but were no match for the winner, Flower Alley, who finished second in last year's Breeders' Cup Classic. In his most recent start, returns to the races victorious. Flower Alley is a chestnut colt, a 4-year-old son of Distorted Humor from Princess Olivia by Lysias, bred in Kentucky by George Brunicini in the Bonaterra farm owned by Melnick Racing and trained by Todd Pletcher. Ridden the victory by John Velasquez, Flower Alley completes the mile on that sloppy surface in 1:35.4. We're going to head back to Monmouth just to give you an idea how quickly things can change. On Sunday, they ran the Coronado's Quest for three-year-olds at a mile and 70 yards. By this point, the track was listed as fast. Let's head down to Monmouth and Sunday's running of the Coronado's Quest.
The racing in the Coronado's Quest. Not a great start there for Praying for Cash. He hopped in the air at the break, and two deals pending, also off slowly. It's Gotcha Gold on the far outside, going out to the front and clearing and getting to the rail. Gotcha Gold has made the lead into the first turn. Praying for Cash has to sit behind him. St. Augustus is right to the outside of him, and then comes a three-wide Grand Survival. He's an old salt. We'll tuck in behind that trio, running in fifth, 5.5 from the front, and the trailer is two deals pending. Gotcha Gold ran a 23 flat quarter, leads the way onto the back stretch by a length and a half. On the far outside, Grand Survival is now into second. Then it's St. Augustus, Praying for Cash, back to fourth along the rail. He's 2.5 lengths off the lead. He's an old salt, pumped on for more by Eddie Castro in fifth, and it's a gap of another 5 to two deals pending, a 46 flat half mile into the far turn. Gotcha Gold by a length and a half as they enter the turn. Grand Survival to the outside. Praying for Cash has the rail. St. Augustus between those two. He's an old salt's got to go wide, and it's a long way back to two deals pending. It's Gotcha Gold. He's got a 2.5 length lead. Now Bravo shakes the reins at Praying for Cash. He wants him to come and go. Three quarters in 1:09.3, and they're into the stretch. And Gotcha Gold is still there, and he's 3.5 lengths in front. Praying for Cash is second. He's an old salt to the outside third. Then St. Augustus and Grand Survival, but it's Gotcha Gold at 15-1, and he's finishing strong to the wire. He's won the Coronado's Quest in 1:39.3.
Gotcha Gold running very impressively on the front end. A win by 7 is the second longest shot on the board at over 15-1. Praying for Cash finishing in the second spot with a bit of a rallying move after an awkward start. He's an old salt, a horse that earlier this year looked to be on the Triple Crown trail, but just didn't continue moving up all that sharply, finishing in the third spot. The winner, Gotcha Gold, won an allowance. Non-winners have won optional claimer most recently at the beginning of June here at Monmouth Park, and obviously handles the surface quite nicely with the blinkers on, getting an extensive victory here. Not sure where they're going to send this three-year-old next. Gotcha Gold is a bay son of Coronado's Quest, out of Gotcha Last by Pleasant Tap. He was bred in Florida by the Centaur Farm and is owned by the breeder. Trained by Eddie Plesa Jr. and ridden to victory by Charles Lopez. Gotcha Gold covers the mile and 70 yards at Monmouth in 1:39.3. We're going to head to Churchill Downs next in the running of the Beau Genius. On the grass for sprinting horses going 5 furlongs on turf, a turf course labeled good. Let's head down to Kentucky, the Beau Genius.
In the gate. Off and running in the Beau Genius. Whistleman Gardens like a shot to take the early lead. Smart enough will join and head that one. It's Handsome I Am up into second on the inside. Whistleman Gardens settles down in third. Grand Escape racing in fourth now. Then Skeleton Crew and 5 back to Stalwartly at the back of the pack. 9 front to back as they sprint into that far turn. Now it's Smart Enough. And Rafael Bejarano opening up by a length and a quarter. It's Handsome I Am back into second. Whistle and Gardens in third. Skeleton Crew racing fourth by 3 to Grand Escape. And Stalwartly tries to pick it up from the back of the pack as they straighten away in the stretch drive. Opening quarter, not that testing. 22 seconds flat in the stretch drive. Smart Enough and Bejarano by a length and a half. It's Handsome I Am coming on to make a race of it. It's still Smart Enough. It's Handsome I Am second. Late charge from Grand Escape. Smart Enough too good here. Smart Enough wins the Beau Genius by a widening 2 at the wire. It's Handsome I Am second, Grand Escape third, then Whistle and Gardens.
Smart Enough, this is kind of an interesting horse. He is a son of Horse Chestnut, who's now 3-for-4 lifetime with a nice 2.25 length win, as the odds on choice over It's Handsome I Am and Grand Escape. Kind of an interesting horse in that he's so lightly raced, nicely bred horse who's come along fairly quickly after 2 sprints and allowance, maiden and allowance win at Pimlico. Trainer John Fisher, who already had a win on the weekend at the Sussex Stakes in Delaware Park, completes a pretty nice double here for the Erdenheim Farm. Smart Enough is a chestnut gelded son of Horse Chestnut from Smart and Quick, from Quick and Smart by Polish Numbers. Bred in Kentucky by F. Eugene Dixon Jr. and owned by Mr. Dixon's Erdenheim Farm, trained by John Fisher and ridden to victory by Rafael Bejarano. Smart Enough covers the 5 furlongs on the turf course, listed as good in 56 2/5. We're going to head north of the border now for a trio of stakes races on Sunday from Woodbine. Obviously, a big day there. It was Queen's Plate Day. We had a couple of other supporting stakes, beginning with the Scots Highlander $200,000 sprint on the grass. Let's head to Woodbine and the Scots Highlander.
They're off in the Scots Highlander Stakes, and Gambler Slew broke sharply. Mark will be good in the center, and toward the hedges, a Lang Fleur. Then there's five lengths to Sophia's Prince, who has Atticus Christie to his outside. Awesome action. And last of them all is Man of Illusion. Man of Illusion is back 10 lengths off the lead of Lang Fleur as they sweep into the far turn. They got an opening quarter mile in a lung opening. 21-4. And it's Lang Fleur at the 3/8 pole, leading it by a length. Gambler Slew is a tracking second. Then Marco Be Good. Atticus Christie's down toward the inside. Man of Illusion trying to get into it as they swing off the turn and come to the quarter pole. It is Lang Fleur off a half in 44-2. Gambler Slew. Man of Illusion is on the far outside and also coming on. Marco Be Good. And Marco Be Good strikes front. Atticus Christie to the inside. Gambler Slew. Atticus Christie trying to run down. Marco Be Good. Here is the wire. Marco Be Good has won the Scots Highlander Stakes to Atticus Christie. A show photo between Sophia's Prince and Awesome Action. 1/5 of a second off the course record.
Marco Be Good, another improving young horse, getting the victory here at 12.5-1. He'd won a couple of races leading into this against a little bit lesser company. Atticus Christie, who is just a very well-known hard-hitting turf sprinter, could not quite get there, was all out and just fell short. Sophia's Prince finishing in the third spot with a nice move. This horse did make a little bit of a rallying move after having had some trouble. Disappointing was Man of Illusion, who was an Australian bred, who had thus far looked very good in all American starts, and went off at just over even money and settled for 5th with a very wide trip. Marco Be Good is a chestnut gelding, a son of Bold and Flashy from Berg Venus by Flying Paster. Bred in Ontario by Dom Romeo and owned by the Terra Farm. Trained by John Ross and ridden to victory by Justin Stein. Marco Be Good covers the 6 furlongs on the Woodbine turf in 107-4. Next up, from sprinters to rooters on the turf, we're going to take a look at the ungraded $100,000 Singspiel for older horses at 1.5 miles. Let's head back to Canada and the Singspiel.
They're off in the Singspiel Stakes. And as expected, broke running. Biblical Scholar is to the inside. And then we have Pellegrino, who settles into third. Jambalaya is nestled in behind horses. Then a Last Answer and Diplomatic Agent is the early trailer. They make that rise toward the back stretch. And it's as expected to dictate the early pace. Mild prompting from a Biblical Scholar, who is on the outside in second position. Last Answer will save some ground as they move to the back stretch. Pellegrino out of trouble on the outside and 2.5 lengths from the front. Then Jambalaya, and at the back of the pack is Diplomatic Agent. They've made that hairpin into the back stretch, and it's as expected. And Eurico Rosa da Silva, they lead it by just over a length, watched intently by Biblical Scholar. The Elkhorn winner, Pellegrino, clear of trouble on the outside, third for John Velasquez, and a length and a quarter off the lead. Last Answer continues to save ground at the hedge. Last year's Breeders' Stakes champion, Jambalaya, is back in 5th position and 4 lengths from the front, and a trailing along the backstretch is Diplomatic Agent. They continue along the backstretch. 3/4 of a mile was in 1:13 and 2/5 of a second, and they're 5 furlongs out in the Singspiel. And it's as expected. Last Answer continues to save ground. Pellegrino's on the outside. In between horses, Biblical Scholar, Jambalaya, ready to take a shot at the leaders with less than 1/2 mile to go. diplomatic agent moves a little closer within six lengths of As Expected with three furlongs to go. As Expected, Jambalaya is coming with a run. Last Dancer is set down. Pellegrino has lost ground, and they come over to the top of the stretch. As Expected, confronted by Jambalaya at the quarter pole, and Jambalaya has swept to the lead. And it's Jambalaya with 3/16 to go. As Expected can find no more. Last Dancer is set down by Emil Ramsamy on the outside and is trying to run down Jambalaya. Jambalaya looking for the wire. Final 16th of a mile. Jambalaya, Last Dancer is surging. Here is the wire. Jambalaya on Gutsavong has won the Singspiel. Last Dancer was second and Diplomatic Agent was third.
Jambalaya, you may remember him as the horse that won by a nose in the Saranac last summer here at Saratoga over Silver Whistle under Jono Jones, making his Saratoga debut. And here gets the win by a game neck under the same rider at the expense of Last Answer and Diplomatic Agent. Favorite in the field was Pellegrino, who was up for this try, but came up a little bit flat after having raced fairly close to the pace. It's also worth noting that Jambalaya has not won since that race up at Saratoga last summer, although last time out he was beaten only a neck by a very nice horse, Remarkable News, in a pretty good race, the Connaught Cup. Jambalaya is a dark bay or brown gelded son of Langfuhr from Muskrat Susie by Vice Regent. Bred in Ontario by Gustav Schuckendans and owned by Kingfield Farm, trained by Catherine Day Phillips, and ridden to victory by Jono Jones. Jambalaya runs the mile and a half on the Woodbine turf in 2:27 flat. Next up, the Queen's Plate for Canadian bred 3-year-olds at a mile and a quarter. The $1 million Queen's Plate is the longest running event, sporting event on the North American continent. Let's head to Canada and the running of the Queen's Plate.
They're off in the Queen's Plate Stakes. Piper's a thunder from the outside. Pyramid Park is showing early speed and the gray Sterwins is right there. Edenwald maintaining position down toward the rail as they move in front of us for the first time. And it's John Velasquez and Sterwins leading under the wire for the first time. Malakoff to attend the pace in second. Wanna runners to the outside of Malakoff. Then we have Edenwald, who will save ground into the first turn, as will Shillelagh Slough, who has Atlas Shrugs alongside. Then Thinking Out Loud and a Pyramid Park. Piper's Thunder, Bridge Cut is out wide. A Seifer Cat has two beaten, Hot Deputy and the late running Ascot Bill. And they head into the backstretch off a half and 45 and 4. This is a hot pace being set out here by Sterwins. Sterwins targeted by Malakoff and Wanna Runner. Edenwald gets a little nudge toward the inside. Then we have Shillelagh Slough, who's back 5 lengths off the lead. Atlas Shrugs runs with Shillelagh Slough. Piper's a Thunder, 7 lengths from the front. Seifer Cat's made up some ground. Pyramid Park, Thinking Out Loud, Ascot Bill, Bridge Cut, and Hot Deputy. 3 furlongs to come, and Edenwald comes on the inside of Sterwins. And it's Edenwald and Sterwins, those two in a heated duel. Malakoff has asked for run, Wanna Runner, not this afternoon, has backed out of it. And they're inside the quarter pole. Edenwald and Sterwins. Who will blink first? Sterwins on the outside. To the inside, Edenwald. Malakoff has flattened out a bit. Then Shillelagh Slough. Edenwald on the inside is running the race of his life. They're in the final 16th of a mile. Edenwald and Emil Ramsamy to win the 147th running of the Queen's Plate. Sterwins was second, a show photo between Malakoff and Ascot Bill.
Edenwald pulling off a bit of a surprise here near the front end every step of the way. Pace setter Sterwins hold on for the second spot, and the pace presser Malakoff finishing in the third spot here. All three finishers very close, top finishers very, very close to the pace. Edenwald was a very promising 2-year-old last summer, won 4 of 8 as a 2-year-old, and was winless yet this season with a third place finish in the plate trial, his best performance thus far. Very disappointing in the field was the favored Wanna Runner, horse who had been mainly out in the West Coast and the Southwest for his connections, Bob Baffert and Mike Pegram. They shipped into town, looked like they had a pretty solid horse, but after pressing the pace, he faded with a four-wide trip on the far turn. The winner, however, Edenwald, pretty strong under the wire, three-quarters of a length the better of the field. Edenwald is a chestnut three-year-old son of Southern Halo from Best of Friends by Mining. Bred in Ontario by Gail Wood and W. Diamant, owned by James and Alice Zapara, trained by Josie Carroll, and ridden to victory by Emil Remsami. Edenwald covers the mile and a quarter on the Woodbine main track in 2:05.1. We're going to pause now for one more brief message, and when we return, we'll be taking a look at Southern California, New York, and heading overseas for a special stakes feature. Please stay with us. Welcome back to Horses and Courses. We're going to continue now in Southern California with the Grade 2 Beverly Hills on the turf for fillies and mares at a mile and a quarter. Let's head out to Southern California and the Beverly Hills.
They're off. Good start. Moscow Burning is absolutely sent and asked for speed. Change of tactics today. They want to make the lead with Moscow Burning, and she will. To the outside goes Dream Lady. Sogol is between horses and Live Life, and now Moscow Burning is going to sit fourth, but she was asked for speed early, and the other three are really flying early. Dream Lady is the leader. Memorette and Delicia are next. Then comes Immortalite, followed by Eternal Melody, and Sissy has to be 20 lengths behind already as they go very fast for a mile and a quarter. Dream Lady and Sogol will set the pace jointly. Dream Lady outside, Sogol at the rail. Live Life races in third, and she's just a length and a half behind, and the top three are going very fast. 22 3/5 seconds to the first quarter of a mile, going a mile and a quarter. Moscow Burning was sent out, and she's 10 lengths behind in fourth. Outside of her, it's Delicia, and Memorette's between horses. Then it's 4 lengths further back to Immortal Light. Eternal Melody still about 15 or 16 from the front, and if Sissy wins the 41st Beverly Hills Handicap, she'll make up 30 lengths as they go by the half mile in 45 4/5 seconds. Gonna be virtually impossible for any of these top three to do it, as Sogol, Dream Lady, and Live Life are across the track, and they are trading punches into the far turn. Stretch runners are looming, and they're coming now. Delicia and Moscow Burning are within four of the lead. Four back to Memorette. Then comes Immortalite. Eternal Melody is still 15 from the front. Sissy's far back, and Live Life is running a monster race. She took all of that heat early, and at the quarter pole, she's going to be three in front. But now, stablemate Delicia is running after her in second. Moscow Burning and Memorette are within five of the lead. That's all for Sogol, and Live Life still has to get over a final furlong. She's 2 lengths in front of Delicia in second. Moscow Burning's at the rail. Memorette is within 3.5 of the lead, and Live Life still has 150 yards to get. Memorette in the center of the course. Moscow Burning between horses. Live Life, Memorette alongside. Here comes Memorette to run by and win. The 41st Beverly Hills Handicap goes to Memorette. Live Life ran entirely too good to lose. Moscow Burning third, Delicia fourth.
Memorette, a bit of a bridesmaid. This was her first graded stakes victory. She had run on the board in some pretty impressive performances against some pretty major company, but here gets the win by 3/4 of a length over Live Life and the favored Moscow Burning, who's a mare who has gone back and forth between graded stakes company and the California bred company with considerable ease, settling for the third spot. The winner, Memorette, a dark Bayer brown filly, a daughter of Memo from Forever Fondra by Sharastani, was bred in California by the Oak Tree Farm and is owned by Betty Curran, trained by her husband, William Curran, and ridden to victory by Victor Espinoza. Memorette covers the 1.25 miles on the Beverly Hills at Hollywood Park in 2 minutes flat. We're going to head right back to that Hollywood turf course and the Cinema Handicap on Sunday. Three-year-olds going a mile and an eighth on the turf course in grade three company. Let's head back to California and the Cinema.
They're off. The 5J's in Niagara Causeway shows speed. New Joyzy Jeff is close to the pace. Chadlington four deep. Outside of him, Global Genius. Film Fortune and Genre are next, and the early trailer is Obrigado. The 5J's fast out of the chute, and he opens up for David Cohen. It's the 5J's, and he sprints away into the clubhouse turn. Now four in front of Niagara Causeway in second. New Joyzy Jeff secures a good striking position for Valdivia. He's third and about 4.5 from the front. Chadlington and Film Fortune have 6 lengths to make up. Global Genius a length behind them. Genre is second to last, now in 7 off the lead, and the trailer is Obrigado as the 5J's takes a breather into the backstretch and only leads now by a measured length and a half. Niagara Causeway tracks him in second, but the 5J's is still strong up the backstretch, and he leads by a length and 3/4. Niagara Causeway is second. New Joyzy Jeff continues to travel comfortably. He's third and 3.5 lengths off the lead. Chadlington and Film Fortune now have 5 to come. Genre's asked to pick off back markers. Outside of him, it's Global Genius. Obrigado is still at the back of the pack, 9 lengths from first to last. The 5J's is still fresh and fit going into the far turn, and he leads by 2 lengths from Niagara Causeway, who's asked to go after him in second. New Joyzy Jeff has asked for his run. He's 3.5 off the lead. Chadlington and Film Fortune now 6 from the front. Genre's all in with 7 lengths to make up. Global Genius backs out of it. Obrigado is still the trailer, and the 5J's is still the leader. The 5J's off the top of the turn leads Niagara Causeway, who's running a big one. New Joyzy Jeff comes with his run, and here comes New Joyzy Jeff down the center of the track. Oh, New Joyzy Jeff has unseated the rider. What the heck happened there? So Niagara Causeway has the lead. Here's Genre between horses. Genre, Niagara Causeway, Genre wins. On a bizarre day at Hollywood Park, Genre wins the Cinema Breeders' Cup Handicap over Niagara Causeway. New Joyzy Jeff was on his way to victory and unseated Jose Valdivia Jr.
Genre, a little bit of an upset here at 5-1, picking up the win from way back off the pace at the expense of Niagara Causeway, who went off at 10-1, got to the lead at the top of the stretch but was caught late. Film Fortune rallies from off the pace to finish in the third spot. The winner, Genre, is a 3-year-old bay son of Orpin from Blue Indigo by Pistolet Blue, bred in Great Britain by T.E. Pocock and owned by David and Paula Mueller. Trained by Ben Cecil and ridden to victory by Martin Pedroza, Genre gets the victory as unfortunately there was an accident in the stretch. New Joyzy Jeff ducked out rather dramatically. Jose Valdivia did fall off. There was an inquiry into the running of the race, but it did appear that no action was taken by the stewards. Genre's position on top will remain. It is worth noting, however, that Jose Valdivia was taken to the hospital following this spill and has been diagnosed with a broken collarbone, and unfortunately, as a result, will be missing a considerable amount of time while he recuperates, and certainly a very difficult time of the year to miss with their Del Mar meet coming up very, very soon. Genre, the winner of the Cinema Handicap for 3-year-olds at 1.125, covers the distance on the Hollywood turf in 147.3. We're going to head right back to Belmont Park now for a pair of stakes over the weekend, beginning with the Grade 2 New York Handicap for older fillies and mares at 1.25. Let's head down to New York and the New York Handicap.
And they're off. Dynamite Lass, and toward the outside, it's Noble Stella. At the fence, Smart and Classy Away running in third, followed by Asi Siempre, and then to her outside, it's Argentina. And the early trailers will be Angara and Omea, as Noble Stella takes the initiative in the early stages here. Dynamite Lass gets a ground-saving position into the turn. Argentina up close and running along third through an opening quarter over this boggy going in 26 flat. So they make their way into the back stretch. Noble Stella is clear now, clear by two. Argentina won't let her get far away. Second and neck over Dynamite Lass, a ground-saving third. Asi Siempre muzzled and suppressed there by Kent DeSormo. Five lengths off the easy pace up front. Just to her outside, it's Angara. To her inside, Smart and Classy. And Omea trails the field about eight or nine from Noble Stella, who gets that opening half mile in 52 3/5 seconds. So they continue down the back stretch, and it's Noble Stella who leads it by a measured length. Over Dynamite Lass on the inside second. Argentina's dropped off just a bit in third position. And then it's Asi Siempre running on well and still well held while fourth. There's room at the inside for Smart and Classy. Smart and Classy tries to get through on the inside, but the rider had a tap on the brakes there when the hole closed. Angara's now five lengths from the front in the clear on the outside, and now Angara is beginning to advance as they round the far turn. Omea's the trailer. Three quarters, 18 2, and they're coming to the top of the stretch. Well off the rail, Noble Stella. A huge opening for Dynamite Lass on the inside. On the outside, Argentina. Just in behind him, Asi Siempre, who's coming on through between horses. And Angara. Angara coming with a flying finish on the far outside. Noble Stella's in front. Angara coming with a relentless run. In between those two, it's Argentina. They're coming down to the finish. Angara and Noble Stella. Noble Stella won by a head over Angara.
Noble Stella slows the pace down on a soft turf course on a rainy afternoon. They certainly did everything they could to maintain this race on the turf, and that turf was very, very soft. Noble Stella, who is often overlooked in the betting, gets a very nice victory here by a neck in a hard-fought effort over Angara, with Argentina the favorite in the field at just under 2-1, finishing in the third spot. The winner, Noble Stella, a dark bay or brown mare, a daughter of Monsun from Noble Pearl by Dashing Blade, was bred in Germany by the Gestüt Etzian and is owned by Gary Tanaka, trained by Roger Atfield, and ridden to victory by Mike Smith. Noble Stella slows the pace down and gallops home in 2:08 1. We're going to head right back to Belmont now in the Mike Lee for three-year-old New York bred, 7 furlongs the distance. Let's head back to Sunday and the running of the Mike Lee.
Baby Rouge, Classic Pack, New Testament, and Fire Went Up on those four, all after that early lead. Ferocious One right there, too. And then it's Raceland back running in sixth, followed by Saratoga Jet, 3 lengths back to Ben Layla. A scramble on for that lead here. And it's Fire Went Up who goes head-to-head with New Testament. On the outside, Baby Rouge runs third, and Ferocious One is now fourth toward the rail. Raceland followed by Classic Pack, Saratoga Jet, Ben Layla at the back. 22 2 was that head-to-head first quarter between Fire Went Up and New Testament, and that's a full-throttle battle around the far turn. 2 1/2 lengths back, Ferocious One just on the inside of Baby Rouge. Then it's another 2 1/2 lengths back. Classic Pack toward the rail on the outside. Saratoga Jet, and they're coming to the top of the stretch. Fire One Up now beginning to prevail over New Testament. But Fire One Up has been softened up. New Testament on the inside is second. Ferocious One comes wide off the turn. Classic Pack is right there. Saratoga Jet on the far outside. Baby Rouge giving way down to the last furlong here. Ferocious One takes the lead. Ferocious One in front. Classic Pack coming up the fence. As Fire Went Up continues the fight on Gamely, and they're coming down to the finish. Ferocious One, Classic Pack, Fire One Up. Here's the wire. Ferocious One narrowly over Classic Pack. And Fire Went Up was close for fourth as well between Saratoga Jet and Ben Layla.
Ferocious One and Edgar Prado getting the win. Not very often you're going to get a little over 5-1 on Edgar Prado and Richard Dutrow, but here they teamed up to win by a neck with a performance very close to the pace every step of the way. Classic Pack rallies from off the pace to finish second. Fire One Up, who tracked the early pace, in fact got to the lead for a brief period during the top of the stretch, the top of the turn, in a nice effort outside of horses, did settle for the third spot. favorite in the field. Very disappointing in this field was Baby Rouge, who I thought would probably run a little bit better. He chased in the early going outside of horses and faded to finish sixth in the field of eight. The winner, Ferocious One, most recently finished third behind Older Allowance horse Pay Attention at the end of May, and obviously the experience against his elders may well have helped him. Ferocious One is a chestnut son of Light the Fuse from Chocolate Ruse by Air Forbes One. Bred in New York by Sandy Goldfarb, owned by Sanford Goldfarb, Ira Davis, Michael Glassberg, and William Vidro. Trained by Richard Dutrow Jr. and ridden to victory by Edgar Prado. Ferocious One covers the 7 furlongs at Belmont Park in 124-4. We do have a special overseas feature for you. We're going to head to Kyoto Racecourse, where on Saturday they contested the Takazuka Kainen, a Group 1, over $2 million for a mile and a 3/8 on the turf. A terrific group of Japanese distance running turf horses. Let's head back, or over rather, to Kyoto Racecourse and the Takazuka Kainen.
Barrier attendant clears away. Stand by. They're ready. Gates are back and away they go. Fast Tatayama, the slowest to begin. Along the fence, Lincoln also slow away. Spearing across from the outside is Balance of Game. Daiwa Major up handy with Hat Trick and Silk Famous. Just in behind them, Cosmo Bolt. Along the fence is Lincoln. In behind them, Company. Then back to Chakra. A further gap to Narita Sentry. Then on the inside of Narita Sentry is Tokai Kum Kum. Deep Impact is second last. Fast Tatayama is last of all. They go into the first corner with 1,600 meters to go. Balance of Game leads the way. A length, Silk Famous. Another length on the inside. On the long defense is Daiwa Major. A length and a half further back to Lincoln. On its outside, Hat Trick. Pressing forward is Cosmo Bulk. Then 2 lengths to Eye Popper. 3 lengths away is Narita Sentry. Then comes a Company. Outside Company is Chakra, then Tokai Kum Kum. Second last is Deep Impact, and last of all is Fast Tatayama. Down the back with 1,200 to run. In fact, they've reached the halfway stage. It's Balance of Game now at the 1,100, leading the way from Silk Famous, then Daiwa Major. A gap to Cosmo Bulk. On the fence is Lincoln. On its outside is Hat Trick. Then 2 lengths back to Eye Popper. Another length and a half away, Narita Sentry. Then a gap back to Company on its outside, Chakra. Well, is he taken off yet? He's starting to creep a little bit forward on Deep Impact. A gap back to Tokai Kum Kum. And last of all is still Fast Tatayama. They've reached the top of the hill at the 800-meter mark. It's Balance of Game from Silk Famous. Daiwa Major and Cosmo Bolt runs fourth. Fifth is Lincoln. Sixth is Hat Trick. Midfield is Eye Popper. Then comes Narita Sentry. Deep Impact not winding up yet. Taking his time. He's just behind them. Then a gap back to Company. Further back to Chakra, then Fast Tatayama and Tokai Kum Kum is last of all. They reach the top of the straight. Balance of Game, but swooping around them quickly is Deep Impact, but they've got to catch Balance of Game and Daiwa Major. Balance of Game leads out from three from Daiwa Major, running on Deep Impact down the middle of the track. It's still Balance of Game, but here comes the champ. Deep Impact swoops up alongside Balance of Game and surges to the lead. Daiwa Major whacking away with the Narita Sentry, but Deep Impact, Kentucky with confidence, puts the whip in the air, goes on and scores by 4 lengths. Narita Sentry got up to run second for Balance of Game. Then a gap on the fence to Company. Further back was Daiwa Major, Tokai Kum Kum, Narita Sentry not far away. Then Cosmo Bolt, Hat Trick, Lincoln knocked up, Chakra. A gap back to Fast Tatayama. Eye Popper failed to run on the ground.
Deep Impact, this horse has just continued to get stronger and stronger. He has only once beaten. He has been very, very impressive. He's now 10 for 11 lifetime, and he does not seem to be showing any signs of slowing down. A very strong performance once again from Deep Impact, a Japanese bred who has really been an absolute monster over there. And they've actually indicated, his connections have indicated, that they are going to likely take this horse to Europe and see if they can compete with the best of the European stock as well, and internationally throughout Europe. And nowadays it seems a lot of other Asian horses and Australian horses are heading to Europe, so the fields over there should be getting stronger. And certainly if this horse does take on some of the best in Europe, it could be very, very interesting to see. Deep Impact picks up the victory by a considerable margin over Narita Sentry. Balance of Game running in the third spot. The winner, Deep Impact, is a bay colt, a son of Sunday Silence from Wind in Her Hair by Alzeo. He was bred in Japan by the Northern Farm and is owned by Kaneko Motoko Holdings trained by Yusuo Iki and ridden to victory by Yutaka Take. Deep Impact covers the mile in 3/8 in a bit of a rainstorm. We had some rain over there, and the course was listed as good in 2:13. That's going to wrap up a busy edition of Horses and Courses. Thank you very much for joining us. We hope you'll be able to join us next time as we take a look at stakes racing action from around the country. Until then, I'm Jean Wood. Have a great week at the races.